Amid a big global pandemic, it literally is the little things that have doctors and politicians fearing the worst. The president here talking about masks.
Incredible. We've ordered millions of them, but we need millions more. This, a thing like this has never been requested, and it's never, we've never had to even think in terms of these numbers.
This morning, the president acknowledged a shortage of medical-grade masks, gloves, and other PPEs, or personal protective equipment. But doctors nationwide are also warning of a looming shortage of ventilators. Going by the numbers, the Society of Critical Care Medicine has projected 960,000 Americans will need to be put on ventilators during this outbreak. But the U.S. only has about 200,000. President Trump this morning announced he's invoked the Defense Production Act to buy and produce medical supplies of all kinds, as if we need them for war.
But there's never been an instance like this where no matter what you have, it's not enough.
Locally, agencies are already rationing. Kaiser Permanente confirmed to KGW it's closing 11 clinics in the area starting tomorrow. We got this list late today. It's on our website and social media feeds now. Some appointments at these spots will be postponed. Others will be moved to virtual visits. And a main goal here is to conserve these supplies for doctors treating COVID-19 patients. That announcement from Kaiser came after this press conference yesterday and this dire warning from Multnomah County Health Officer Jennifer Vines.
We anticipate that the way that we're using them now at our current what we call burn rate, that supplies may be depleted in approximately 2 weeks.
That's a local Portland area prediction. Statewide, there is a stockpile of this stuff, but the Oregon Health Authority confirms it's running dry. Doctors have already used 28% of the N95 or respiratory masks, 63% of surgical masks, and 83% of surgical gowns. It's enough to make people in other industries want to pitch in.
We had loads of them. I actually just got a case yesterday or a few days ago.
Laura Tigert is an esthetician and owner of Opaline Skin Studio in Northwest Portland. She has boxes of medical-grade gloves, masks, and disinfectant wipes that she now can't use. Last night, she put a call out on social media asking for others in the same boat who can help. At a time when paychecks have flat-out stopped, no one is thinking twice about donating.
I know that this is going to be very devastating to a lot of people in our industry because a lot of us are self-owners. And so it makes, hopefully, if we can contribute and help the medical field get this under control a little bit easier and faster, then we can go back to work and do what we love and helping our clients.
Now, just to remind everybody, typically this would be where Maggie and I were in the studio talking about her story, but we have a lot of our reporters, Maggie included, working remotely right now, not coming into the newsroom for obvious reasons. So she joins us right now from her apartment, actually. So just this afternoon, Maggie, we saw some late developments and things actually starting to come together in this. Can you talk about that a bit?
Yeah, Dan, that's right. So as you heard in that piece, basically there are a lot of people who work in medical fields or fields where they need that kind of gear who want to donate. And we just found out from the county that they are opening up locations starting tomorrow morning to do that. That's two locations starting tomorrow, the Portland Fire Logistics Warehouse at Southeast 13th and Gideon. It's 1300 Southeast Gideon, and the Multnomah County Health Department, which is at 619 Northwest 6th Avenue. It's across from Union Station. So those are two locations starting tomorrow, open basically normal business hours, Monday through Friday, where people who, again, have those supplies can come and drop them off. They'll be distributed to local hospitals in the Portland metro area. So that's a big deal. We also were told earlier today that Governor Kate Brown is working on a similar system to impact hospitals statewide to help them with these shortages. She hasn't made that final yet or come up with the details yet. We don't have a timeline on that, but when we find out how that's going to work, we'll obviously make it widely known and let everybody know.
And those addresses, again, if you at home are wondering the specific locations we can do these drop-offs. Yeah. Maggie, have those shared on social media and stuff like that?
We do, yeah.
Okay. Also, and I want to reiterate this to everyone at home because I know so many people are looking to help out right now. We're talking about medical grade equipment, right?
We are, yeah. So you and I were just talking. This does not mean that your cleaning gloves are needed, as nice as that of the thought that would be. This is medical grade supplies. So like the woman that you saw on the piece, she's an esthetician. She has gloves that are of this standard. She has them sitting in her back room, and she's hearing about this shortage, and she's thinking, I don't need these right now. Let me give those to the doctors and medical workers on the front line. So that's what we're talking about here.
Got it, Maggie. Thank you. Also, to everyone at home, keep sending in those questions, those comments. If you're curious about what's happening with medical supplies, how you can help out, please reach out to us. Use the hashtag #HeyDan.